Hello and welcome to UTS Library's tutorial on PubMed, one of the world's top health databases developed by the National Library of Medicine in the United States. It contains more than 30 million citations of peer-reviewed biomedical and life sciences literature and also contains the contents of Medline. In this video, we will use the PubMed Advanced Search Builder, which allows you to run systematic searches on complex topics. We will use it to find information on volunteers in the palliative care sector. Before beginning an advanced search in PubMed, we recommend using a table to break down your research question into concepts and keywords to perform a more thorough search. To access PubMed, go to the library search page, click databases at the top of the page, then search PubMed. Select PubMed and log in with your UTS ID and password. In PubMed, select the Advanced tab. In the Advanced Search Builder, we will begin entering each of our search words one by one to build our search. The reason we don't search for all our words at once is to give us more freedom later on, after we have run the search, to easily remove or change terms which aren't helping our search. To start, we will begin adding the subject headings and keywords for concept group 1. Click on the drop-down box, choose mesh terms, enter the subject heading palliative care, and click add. Next, palliative care will drop down into the query box. Click on the drop-down arrow next to search and select add to history. Once you have clicked add to history, your first search word will appear in the history and search details and display how many results it has returned. The remaining search words in concept group 1 are keywords, and we'll search for these as text words, which looks for your words in the title, abstract, and subject headings of articles. Click on the drop-down box and choose text word. Then repeat the same process as before in adding a search word. Once you've entered all the words from concept group 1 into the history and search details, you want to add them together to make your first concept group. To do so, click on the three dots next to each of your searches. Select Add Query for the first query you add, and then Add with OR for the remaining. Your searches will all be added to the query box above. Once you have added all your searches for Concept Group 1 to the query box, click on Add to History. Now, all of your words in Concept Group 1 have been combined. Repeat the same process for your next concept group, Volunteers. After you've made all your concept groups, you need to add them together in the query box. Click on the three dots next to concept group 1 and select Add Query. Then, click on the three dots next to concept group 2 and select Add with AND. Then, click on Add to History. Now the search is completed and has returned your results. Click on the number to view your results and look at the titles and summaries. You can refine your search by using the filtering tools on the left-hand side. Let's refine our results under article type to randomize controlled trials and systematic reviews, and to articles published in the last 5 years under publication date. There is the option to further refine your search by selecting additional filters, where you can narrow your search by language, such as English. If you need to make any changes to your search, select Advanced to modify it. To read the full article, click on an article and choose an option under Full Text Links. To export articles to your referencing software, tick the boxes next to the articles you want, then click on Send To, Citation Manager, and select Create File. You can save selected articles or email them to yourself, or create an alert to stay up to date with new articles added to the database that match your search strategy. To set this up, you will need to create a free PubMed account. In this video, we covered how to use the Advanced Search Builder in PubMed to add mesh and text words to your search and combine your concept groups together, how to refine your search, how to create an alert to stay up to date with new articles, how to find full text articles, and how to export articles to referencing software. If you have any questions, contact us using the Ask a Librarian link on the library homepage.